me a god.
First up, we have Subnautica. This game is a beautifully immersive experience with a wide variety of biomes to discover. From stunning neon reefs to treacherous underwater caverns, Subnautica will both amaze and terrify you. It taps into our primal fears of the ocean, drowning, and the unknown monsters lurking in the deep. But don't worry, it's also one of the most relaxing games out there. You can spend hours exploring, mining for materials, and building bases. When we heard it was coming to the Switch, we were skeptical about how it would perform, but Unknown Worlds has delivered a solid port that offers one of the best survival experiences on any platform. Next on our list is Endless Ocean Luminous. This game allows you to embark on solo dives, starting fresh each time or continuing from where you left off. The gameplay is simple. Explore the underwater world, tag creatures, and discover secrets. You'll come across shipwrecks, caves, and even underwater temples. One of the best moments in the game is when you encounter massive creatures emerging from the abyss or stumble upon hidden structures. There are also moments when you have to interact with specific animals to unlock new paths. I mean, who wouldn't want to be friends with a giant turtle? Overall, Endless Ocean Luminous offers a serene and captivating experience for all underwater explorers. Abzu. This game focuses on delivering stunning visuals and a mesmerizing soundtrack that enhances your journey through the ocean depths. The graphics have a stylized and low-poly aesthetic that creates dreamlike seascapes. The attention to detail, like schools of fish and predators, creates a living ecosystem. The game also features wide shots that emphasize the diver's insignificance compared to the vastness of the ocean. The soundtrack is hauntingly beautiful, with orchestral melodies and even a choir. The music dynamically changes based on what's happening on the screen, adding to the immersive experience. I highly recommend playing this game in portable mode with headphones to fully appreciate the 3D sound and get lost in the underwater world. Dave the Diver. This game is filled with unique animations and a great sense of humor. The upgrade system, like crafting new weapons and upgrading dishes, comes with hilarious animations that will keep you entertained. It's incredible how many of these cutscenes there are. The gameplay tasks are also satisfying, with well-animated and realized tasks. The service aspect of the game provides benefits for Dave's diving exploits, creating a perfect blend of gameplay elements. Just like a Mario game, Dave the Diver keeps you engaged with its constant rotation of new ideas and mechanics. It's a game that will surely capture your attention like few others. Our next game is Dredge. This action RPG game offers a vast encyclopedia of over 125 fish for you to discover. The upgrade system in Dredge is addicting, and once you reach the point where your boat is upgraded, the difficulty is manageable, and the story is in full flow. It becomes magical. The presentation of the terrifying ocean is spot on, making you feel the need to push the boundaries of safety to catch your prey. The sound design adds to the immersive experience, with slapping rain and eerie creaks. Dredge offers a mix of angling in the sunshine and the thrill of managing your inventory. It's a game that you'll want to showcase on your gaming shelf. Maneater. a game with a unique concept and solid performance on the Nintendo Switch. Despite its initial bugs and issues, this Switch port provides a smooth and visually impressive experience. Whether you play docked or in portable mode, Maneater runs perfectly, with only minor glitches encountered. Evolving your shark from a fragile orphan to a mega deathbringer is a thrilling experience, and tearing humans to shreds never gets old. The narrator, Chris Parnell, delivers an excellent performance that adds to the overall enjoyment. Although the combat can feel repetitive and the lack of variety in side missions is disappointing, Maneater still has the potential to be a great time with a few adjustments.
She's sure making a lot of splashes.
Let's build a zoo, Aquarium Odyssey. In this DLC, the goal is to create an amazing aquarium empire to house the magnificent creatures of the ocean. It's not just about showcasing these creatures, but also about preserving their habitat and providing a safe and clean environment for them to thrive in. With increased pollution and overfishing in the real world, it's crucial that we create a virtual space where these magnificent creatures can be protected. In this new campaign, you'll have to start your aquarium from scratch, which means taking on fresh tasks given by NPCs. These tasks could include creating hybrids, increasing the number of visitors, or even collecting fish poop. The variety of tasks keeps the game engaging and encourages exploration of different management aspects. Moving on to our next game, we have SpongeBob SquarePants: The Cosmic Shake. This game offers a well-paced and consistent experience throughout. There's always something new to collect, or a costume to unlock, which keeps the game exciting. Once you've completed the main quests in a few worlds, the game really opens up, allowing you to backtrack and progress further in the story. The developers, Purple Lamp Studios, have done an excellent job in creating this platformer, and it's clear that a lot of effort was put into making it the best SpongeBob game yet. However, there are some minor performance issues that come with the enhanced visuals. The frame rate may drop when the screen gets busy, and there are occasional graphical hiccups. But overall, these issues don't significantly impact the gameplay experience. Far Lone Sails. This game offers a unique and immersive experience where every action you take is guided by common sense and curiosity. There are no on-screen prompts or tutorials. You'll have to figure out everything through trial and error. The gameplay revolves around maintaining a vehicle, making sure you have enough fuel, controlling the accelerator, and venting steam. It may sound mundane, but it's oddly satisfying to watch your vehicle's millimeter tick away as you successfully keep it running. As you progress, you'll come across useful tools like a vacuum for collecting fuel sources and a sail to conserve energy. The more time you spend with this strange contraption, the more you'll understand its mechanics and quirks. It becomes a part of your story and adds to the overall immersive experience. Splatoon 3. This game offers much more than we expected, with its vibrant hub world called Splatsville. Here you can showcase your collection in a custom locker system, which is surprisingly fun to use. Although it may not have any impact on the gameplay itself, it's enjoyable to try and fit as much Splatoon-related stuff into your locker as possible. And if you're not into that, you can also indulge in the new in-game card game called Table Turf Battle. This side game offers unique and wacky shapes for you to lay down and ink as much of the table's turf as possible. It's a well-thought-out addition to an already content-packed game.
I feel like I'm losing my mind. Is everybody in the world blind? Please, Lord, give me a sign, a sign. I feel like I'm losing my mind.